boat-to-boat and boat-to-shore communications have come a long way since the days of semaphores and flags.
In the 1970s, very high-frequency, or VHF, radios made boat-originated voice communications a reality. And shortly thereafter, digital selective calling, or DSC, added electronic automation to the transmission of urgent distress calls and routine messages. Today, DSC controllers are often integrated with VHF radios to transmit the exact latitude and longitude along with other boat-specific information, essentially a digital mayday call.
VHF-DSC radios, mobile phones, electronic position indicating radio beacons, personal locator beacons, and I-911 now offer many choices to boat operators.
Since the primary purpose of marine communications is safety, the VHF-DSC radio with line-of-sight transmission should be your first choice. A chief advantage is point-to-multi-point signal broadcasting, which in case of an emergency or hazard, notification simultaneously alerts all nearby vessels. In addition, you can monitor commercial traffic communications and listen to required and appropriate radio calls.
Permanently installed versions, thanks to antenna height and power, provide a 25-mile range, while handhelds, limited to 6 watts, can reach 12 miles.
Most models can now automatically scan every U.S. and international channel, plus several weather channels, as well as emergency channel 16, which power-driven vessels of 20 meters or more are required to monitor, and all boaters are encouraged to monitor while underway, and provide immediate access to the Coast Guard and other rescue agencies. Recent innovations include compact energy-efficient units that are waterproof and float.
Mobile phone use on boats has become so prevalent that the concern now is safety, as it is for car drivers, due to negative impact on situational awareness. Coverage can be unreliable, and service is point-to-point rather than broadcast to all in-range receivers. So, mobile should not be relied upon as your sole communications device.
Emergency position indicating radio beacons, or EPIRBs, and personal locator beacons, or PLBs, relay text messages using satellites to ensure delivery no matter where you may be boating. Some are standalone units, others pair with your mobile phone to convert the signal from terrestrial to satellite.
EPIRBs are registered to specific boats and alert search and rescue services by transmitting a coded message over a free-to-use multinational satellite network. A 406 megahertz distress frequency signal is sent by satellite to the nearest rescue coordination center, along with a homing signal at 121.5 megahertz to pinpoint the beacon's location. EPIRBs can either be activated automatically, typically by submersion, or manually, and transmit for a minimum of 48 hours.
PLBs work in the same way as EPIRBs by sending a coded message on the same distress frequency through a global satellite system with a homing signal, also at the same frequency as EPIRBs, to pinpoint their location. But PLBs are designed to be registered to a person rather than a boat, are much smaller, must be manually activated using a three-step process, and transmit for a minimum of 24 hours.
When choosing between an EPIRB and PLB for your ditch pack, also consider that EPIRB antennas float, while PLBs do not, and whether you're more concerned about a sinking incident or falling overboard, as well as whether you'll be sleeping aboard while underway.
In an age where smartphones are an essential part of everyday life, the new I-911 system is another tool that can be used to provide rapid assistance to boaters. The tool was approved for use by the U.S. Coast Guard in spring 2020, following a pilot program conducted by the Coast Guard's Research and Development Center.
I-911 pairs consumer smartphone technology with a web-based interface that the Coast Guard uses to locate distressed mariners. The technology uses the internal GPS of a cell phone to send a boat's location to a digital chart accessed by command center personnel. Its accuracy is often within a range of less than 10 feet. And depending on the cell phone service, I-911 can determine the locations of mariners in distress up to 20 nautical miles offshore.
While this new technology is highly effective, boat operators are advised that I-911 should not replace VHF-DSC radios. VHF Channel 16 remains your most robust and reliable means of distress communication.